is Good Morning Indiana, working for you.
It is 5 o'clock here on your Monday. Good morning to you. I'm Lauren Casey. Here's what's making headlines on this July 20th. As COVID-19 cases in Indiana and across the country continue to rise, major retailers are stepping up their mask policies. Working for you will break down which stores you'll need to wear a mask in and how customers are reacting to the change. And dozens took to downtown to protest Marion County's mask mandate, why they say the order is an overstep by the government. Plus, the pandemic has changed the way that some organizations are able to help those in need. How one group is reinventing the way it offers housing to families during this time. But first, here at 5 o'clock, we want to welcome you into Good Morning Indiana and get a check of your forecast. Todd Clausen is standing by from home right now with a check of the radar. Todd, it is an active morning here across central Indiana.
Yeah, you know, still some rain on radar, Laura. Nothing like we saw yesterday afternoon and evening, though, with those heavy thunderstorms that came through and prompted a few severe thunderstorm warnings. This is all just some general light rain that is falling across the area. And you can see this is a 2-hour loop that I have on for you, and the rain continues to diminish and fall apart. So that's good news going forward. Just some light showers here from Rockville up towards the Crawfordsville area, then into Lebanon, over towards the Danville area, and then around the metro area, a few spotty showers in downtown Indianapolis, Noblesville, down to Greenwood, and then over towards the Greenfield area. And then off to the east, we have an isolated shower or two as well, and nothing more than that. And all this should continue to diminish pretty quickly this morning. But we will be left with the cloud cover, so it won't be the brightest start to our day, but we will have some sunshine, I think, working in as we get into the afternoon hours. Just going to have to be a little bit patient. Temperatures are in the 60s and 70s this morning, and we'll get up into the mid-80s, even with the cloud cover that will be present. Look for a high today right around 86 to 87 degrees. The humidity, it's up there a little bit today, but it's not terrible, so just be a little bit patient this morning for the showers to continue to diminish, and then overall, mainly dry Monday for us as we go throughout the course of the day. Lauren.
Todd, thank you. Let's take a look in the downtown area right now at traffic. This is I-65 near Washington Street, where you can see everything is traveling up to speed, both northbound and southbound here between the splits. So that is good news. If you're heading out to work this morning, watch for any ponding out there from some rain showers that we got. Plus, keep in mind, as you're heading southbound in this area, you will not be able to take I-70 West. It's only open to Meridian Street and local traffic. They continue to work on that project from NDOT between the downtown area all the way over to the west side, set to last through July 28th. Starting this week, you'll need to wear a mask to enter more businesses across central Indiana. More corporations are mandating masks for the health and safety of customers and staff. And our Alyssa Donovan is joining us live this morning. Alyssa, Kroger, we know, is one of those stores that is implementing this policy.
That's right, Lauren. And although the one downtown, it was already required to wear a mask because of the mayor's mandate for Marion County, all of the Krogers across Indiana will now start having that mask mandate. It's going to start this coming Wednesday, so you have a few days to get ready, find a mask, and be prepared to walk in the door with a mask on when you do shop at local Krogers. And that's just one of many businesses that are starting this mask mandate this week. A long list of businesses will start requiring masks today, including Cunningham and Hughes Culinary, two well-known Indianapolis-based restaurant groups. The restaurants they own include Brew Burger, Livery, St. Elmo, and Harry and Izzy's. Mask policies at Walmart and CVS will also take effect this week, just to name a couple. Now, we asked people in downtown Indianapolis how they feel about the mandates.
I think it's hot, it's annoying sometimes, but it's the safest way, you know? It's the safest thing we can do. Keep everybody else safe, keep us safe. We don't want anybody to get sick.
I think it's really silly. We should be able to make our own decisions. If we feel that we're at high risk, then, you know, then we act appropriately.
And many businesses and communities that require masks are also providing them for free to people in need. And for all the details on which stores and which businesses are going to start those mask mandates this weekend, which day, what you need to know, you can visit theindychannel.com. We have all of the information there. Reporting live, Alyssa Donovan, RTV6.
Alyssa, thank you. The time right now is 5:04. Dozens of people right here in central Indiana are rallying against those mandates for wearing masks. They took to the State House on Sunday. today, calling the Marion County mask mandate an overreach by the government. The organizers believe that the requirement is all for all is an overstep because they say all immune systems are not the same.
I don't need to wear a mask for them to be safe. I'm responsible for my own health. They're responsible for their health.
The group called Stop Government Overreach in Indiana hosted this rally. They are also upset that the governor has kept the state at 4.5 instead of continuing to reopen. Holcomb has stressed the importance of masks amid the resurgence of cases in the last few weeks. Well, Indiana saw an increase in daily reported COVID-19 cases over the weekend with nearly 1,800 new cases. The State Department of Health reporting 855 new cases Saturday and 927 on Sunday. That is the second highest daily number since the pandemic began. The state's total cases now stand at 56,571. The number of new deaths remained low over the weekend, with 17 reported Saturday, 2 deaths reported Sunday. More than 26,000 Hoosiers have died from the virus so far. Nearly 627,000 people have been tested in our state so far as well. An Indianapolis organization is getting innovative when it comes to helping Hoosiers keep a roof over their heads. This morning, our Kelsey Anderson is working to show you how a new program, possibly unlike any other in the nation, is putting families on the path towards success, and it hasn't slowed down despite the pandemic.
For some Hoosiers, their normal is calling a motel room home. That is, until the money runs out and they have nowhere to go. And thanks to Family Promise of Indianapolis, they're helping those families get back on their own 2 feet. That was the case for Leola Jimenez and her son. Families like the Jimenezes are given up to 90 days to focus all of their attention and savings on getting into their own place. Family Promise guides them every step of the way to set them up for success once they leave the program.
We worked with a few different partnerships, one of them being Mustard Seeds. They're our furniture bank where they assisted with furnishing almost all our units, almost to the T, where everything that Mustard Seeds didn't get, we have 1,500 volunteers in those 30 congregations and churches and temples we work with that worked to put all the household items in here. So families came into the units with dishes, silverware, all cleaning supplies.
I don't even know the last time I was able to cook in the kitchen because it's been like that long. Make us feel like we're family.
Program Director Veronica Williams says they are now operating at 89% success rate, the highest rate they've ever seen of people being housed. Some landlords that are involved in the program will let those tenants just take over the lease once they're ready and those 90 days are up, while other landlords will only let them rent for 30 to 90 days. But once they've completed the program, they go to the top of the list for other units in the complex. Working for you, Kelsey Anderson, RTV 6.
Kelsey, thank you. This morning, we are learning more about an officer-involved shooting that left one man dead on Indy's northeast side. Police were called to North Parker Avenue just before midnight Saturday for a domestic disturbance. When officers arrived, they say a man came outside and started shooting at officers. Police say one officer returned fire and the man went back inside. IMPD says at least 3 homes were damaged from the suspect's gunfire, including a home where police say bullets narrowly missed a 21-month-old baby who was sleeping. After initially negotiating with the crisis team, police say the man stopped communicating. The SWAT team later made entry due to medical concerns, and the suspect again fired at the officers. SWAT team fired back, injuring the man. He was taken to the hospital where he later died. An internal affairs investigation is underway right now. The time right now is 5:08 on our Monday. Let's check in with Todd and see what we can expect as we head out the door this morning. Hey, Todd.
Hey, Lauren, good morning to you. Good morning, everybody. Happy Monday. Hope you had a great weekend. We had those storms that came through yesterday evening and even into the afternoon hours. And we still have some lingering showers that are out there this morning, but they continue to diminish. That is the good news. So you may need that extra cup of coffee here on this Monday morning to get you going. And temperatures are sitting right around 70 degrees. For the most part, though, I think the morning commute is going to be dry because as we go over to your satellite radar picture, you can see that the showers are continuing to become less and less as far as coverage goes across the area. So it's really a hit or miss shower in the forecast this morning, and even into the afternoon there could be a stray shower, but the overall trend will be for the clouds to decrease. And temperatures today, even with the cloud cover that will be around at times, we should easily climb up into the low to mid 80s, putting us in very seasonable territory for your high temperature. We'll talk more about your extended forecast coming up in just a little bit, Lauren.
All right, Todd, thanks so much. Government leaders are set to hammer out a new coronavirus aid package. What they plan to include and additional unemployment benefits are set to expire. And after months of delay, MLB baseball is back this week. Still ahead, how the Cubs and White Sox brought baseball back to Wrigley Field and what players are doing to stay safe while they play. It's 5:10. We'll be right back. It is 5:13 this morning. The country's COVID-19 death toll has surpassed 140,000. And while the virus rages on, another debate is heating up today between the president and his very own party as top congressional Republicans are expected to meet and try and hammer out a new virus aid package. ABC's News' Karina Mitchell is in New York right now with more details.
This morning, President Trump playing defense.
I heard we had one of the lowest, maybe the lowest mortality rate anywhere in the world.
That claim false. Data from Johns Hopkins University showing the U.S. with a higher mortality rate than Russia and about tied with Brazil. As daily U.S. cases approach 70,000, the president on Fox News continuing his assertion coronavirus will eventually disappear.
Many of those cases are young people that would heal in a day. They have the sniffles and we put it down as a test.
The mayor of hard-hit Los Angeles not buying it, saying another shutdown is looming.
I think we're on the brink of that.
In Texas, one of eight states setting new records for daily deaths, officials bringing in refrigerated mobile morgues as hospitals are overwhelmed.
There are going to be deaths, and we have to plan ahead for that.
In Florida, 12,400 new cases on Sunday, one of its highest daily totals. Despite the surge, ABC News confirming the president is balking at the idea of approving a Senate Republican plan for $25 billion in new funding for virus testing and tracing, as well as grants for the CDC and NIH. A White House official says Trump is fully committed to, quote, a robust aid package that addresses real needs. That funding fight could stand in the way of a plan for a new coronavirus package. Without any agreement, more than 25 million Americans could lose $600 a week in federal unemployment benefits that started in March. Karina Mitchell, ABC News, New York.
It is 5:15. President Trump's campaign is adding telerallies to its event schedule instead of more in-person events due to the pandemic. The first telerally was directed at Wisconsin voters on Friday. During the 23-minute call, Trump took swings at presumptive Democratic nominee Joe Biden, discussing COVID-19 and the future of his rallies.
I wanted to be with you, and this is really replacing our rallies that we all love so much. We had great rallies in Wisconsin and all over the country. And unfortunately, until this gets solved, and we're doing really well with the therapeutics and vaccines, but until that gets solved, it's going to be tough to have those big, massive rallies. So I'm doing telephonic rallies.
Well, the Trump campaign clarifies it's not ruling out the in-person rallies completely. The decision comes after his rally in Tulsa, Oklahoma, which saw a smaller turnout and was followed by a surge in COVID-19 cases. Linkin Park is the latest band to tell the Trump campaign to stop using its music. The president retweeted a video featuring the song In the End Saturday night. The band responded in a tweet of its own saying it doesn't endorse the president. It adds that a cease and desist order has been issued. Neil Young, the Rolling Stones, and Tom Petty have all demanded the Trump campaign stop using their music as well. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration has given emergency approval for COVID-19 pool testing. The move will allow multiple people to be tested at once, and it will be through Quest Diagnostics, which can take up to four individuals at once for coronavirus. The FDA commissioner said that sample pooling is an important step that helps COVID-19 tests get them to more Americans more quickly while preserving the testing supplies. This is the first COVID-19 diagnostic test in the U.S. to be authorized for use with pooled samples. Delta Airlines says it is doubling down on its mask requirements. The company says it will enforce the policies more strictly starting today. It says people who can't cover their faces for medical reasons should consider staying home. If they do want to fly, they will require those passengers to complete a phone health screening first. They will use those results to determine if a traveler can board without a mask. Delta is the first airline to enact a pre-departure medical clearance as part of its mask policy. Credit and debit card companies are seeing a boom, and Apple Pay has more users than ever. The national coin shortage is driving more and more consumers in this direction. It comes as a lot of companies are starting to ask for exact change or plastic only. Places like Kroger are rounding up to the next dollar on purchases and offering to put the change in a store gift card or donate it to a local food bank. At 5:17, let's check in with Todd and see what we can expect in our Monday forecast. Hey, Todd.
Hi, Lauren. Good morning. We're going to be talking about seasonal temperatures today, and we'll also have the opportunity for some showers here this morning. But overall, I think our Monday is going to be a pretty decent day for us across almost all of central Indiana. That is the good news. Can't rule out the chance of a spot shower, as I mentioned this morning or later on this afternoon, but no real storms in the forecast for us. That is the good news, at least today. But there is more storms in the forecast in the coming days as our weather pattern remains pretty unsettled here throughout the entire week. There's a few flood issues across parts of the Terre Haute area with some flood advisories, but those should drop off pretty quickly here this morning. And the showers continue to diminish. Just some light rain showers now from Greencastle to Rockville to Bainbridge. And then around the metro area, there's a few spotty showers as well. And then as we slide further off to the east, some light rain from Newcastle into northern portions of Wayne County there, just north of I-70 as you make your way off towards the east. These showers probably not going to hamper travel much at all. They'll be able to wet the ground, but you're not talking about the big time puddles that we saw yesterday that caused some issues out there on the roadways with those heavy thunderstorms that came through. And as we look at a different type of radar, you notice the showers even look less potent. So we'll just have to get through a few sprinkles really for the next hour or so, I think, and that's just about it. The clouds, though, they're going to linger longer. They too will start to move out or burn off and decrease in coverage as we go throughout the course of the day, but you're just going to have to be pretty patient. Don't think of today as one of those days where it's going to clear really, really quickly. We're just going to have to see these clouds thin a little bit and then get into the sunshine as the day progresses. Temperature-wise, everybody's within a couple degrees of each other this morning in the 60s and 70s. As we work our way throughout the day today, while the clouds are in place this morning and they're pretty thick, the temperatures won't really move much at all. And then as they start to thin as the day progresses, that's when we'll see our highs get up into the low to mid 80s across the area. Tomorrow, temperatures are still in the mid 80s. Tomorrow, there will be the chance of some thunderstorms, though, returning to the forecast. So today, it's just the spotty rain showers. But watch as we work our way into tomorrow afternoon on TrueCast. You can see these isolated storms starting to make their way into the area. And some of the storms tomorrow could be on the strong to maybe severe side once again. So that's something we'll have to keep an eye on for you. More storms through Friday, but no days of washout. And then the 90s return to the forecast, Lauren, for Saturday and Sunday.
All right, Todd, thank you. Let's take a look at traffic right now. This is on the southeast side, I-465 and I-74. Traffic in this area is moving along up to speed in both directions, all directions, really, as you can see there on your screen. We'll continue to keep a close eye on your roads this morning as you're heading out there to start a brand new work week, and we'll let you know if there are any issues you need to avoid. Here at 520, Facebook's biggest advertiser in 2020 has announced it is drastically cutting back on using its platform. Disney says it will no longer be spending much money on Facebook and Instagram ads. It joins a growing list of companies that have pulled advertising from the platform. Although Disney has not officially said if the move is part of the Stop the Hate for Profit boycott, economists speculate it could also be due to the pandemic cutting into advertising budgets. Well, sports fans are celebrating the return of baseball. MLB exhibition games began this weekend without fans. Last night, the Yankees and the Mets faced off for their second game in New York. Players were socially distanced in the dugouts, and some chose to wear masks while out on the field. The stands were also filled with cardboard cutouts. Aaron Judge had a huge day with 2 home runs and 3 RBIs in the Yankees' 6-0 shutout. And last night, there was action at Wrigley Field as well. The Chicago Cubs played the White Sox in the late-night exhibition game. The Cubs lost the lead in the fifth after the Sox scored 6 runs to the Cubs 2. The White Sox stayed on top to win 7-3. They'll play again tonight at 8:10, this time at Guaranteed Rate Field. While the stadiums were empty for last night's games, they weren't quiet. The MLB says it was playing crowd noise from its video game over the ballpark speakers. Stadium sound engineers have access to 75 different sound effects to choose from. The video game noise was created over several seasons using recordings of old games. Professional soccer leagues like the Premier League also used a similar system for their games. That's pretty funny. Well, today marks 51 years since the man first landed on the moon. After the break, we'll look back at the history of that moment and why Moon Day is not a national celebration. It's 522. We'll be right back. Today is Moon Day. It marks the 51st anniversary of man's first lunar landing. President Richard Nixon made the first Moon Day a proclamation for July 20th in 1971, 2 years after the Apollo 11 landing. 12 states have since passed bills to recognize the day, but it has not been declared a national day. The landing was watched by millions all around the world, and it's when astronaut Neil Armstrong famously described it as one small step for man and one giant leap for mankind. So, Tom, happy Moon Day to you. You were saying earlier you love space. It has to do a lot with the weather, and so does the moon. So pretty exciting. Moon Day.
Yeah, Moon Day. I forgot all about that. So 51st anniversary. Well, not that we landed on the moon, but there's actually a moon day outside right now. It's tough to see the moon with all the clouds that are in place across the area. And some of those clouds producing a few showers, although as you look at Storm Team 6 radar, you can see those showers diminishing. It's really probably nothing more now than a few sprinkles here and there across the area. So just don't be shocked if you're walking out the door within the next hour or so and you feel a sprinkle or two, but nothing that's going to hamper any workout plans that you have this morning or commute if you have to do that. Temperature-wise, eventually into the 80s later on this afternoon. The clouds will thin for a little bit of sunshine as we go throughout the course of the day. But overall, I would say it's probably going to trend more mostly cloudy and then partly sunny. But nonetheless, it's not a bad way to kick off the week. It does remain unsettled in the forecast, though, for much of this week. More on that coming up in just a little bit.
This is Good Morning Indiana, working for you.
It's 5:30 on your Monday morning, and more businesses will now require you to wear a mask starting today. This morning, we're hearing from those for and against this new requirement.
Plus, a new project is giving shelter to those who need it. Working for you, we're looking at why the initiative may be one of the only of its kind in the nation. But first, here at 5:30, I want to welcome you into Good Morning Indiana. Thanks for kicking off your work week and your Monday with our team. I'm Lauren Casey. Rafael Sanchez joining us now from his Johnson County studio. Rafael, good morning to you.
Lauren, good morning to you. I hope you had a great weekend. It was rather warm, and Todd, as we're waking up, I can hear my gutters with the drip, drip, drip of the rain. Is the rain ending this morning, or is it going to get more of a gutter workout today?
You know, the rain is coming to an end. That is the good news, Rafael, but it's so humid out there. There's a lot of condensation as well, so that condensation is probably falling off your roof into the gutters as well, giving you that dripping sound. And the humidity was with us all weekend long, and we're just kind of carrying that over, even though the temperatures are going to be a little bit cooler here into your Monday. Here's a live look at Storm Team 6 radar, and you can see the showers are continuing to diminish across the area. Some light showers in Bainbridge, Greencastle, up towards Brownsburg and Lebanon, a few spotty sprinkles in the metro area right now. But overall, the trend again will be for less in the way of shower activity this morning and for sunshine to return this afternoon as the clouds thin out in just a little bit. 69 right now in Martinsville, 70 in Greenfield, 71 is the current temperature in Indy. Throughout the morning hours, it's pretty cloudy, and then again, those clouds will thin for some sunshine as the day progresses. Once we get into that sunshine, temperatures will climb up into the mid 80s. 80s. Still a little humidity around throughout the day today, but it's not as high as it was over the course of the weekend. Lauren.
All right, Todd, thanks so much. Let's take a look at traffic as you're heading out on the roads this Monday. This is on the northwest side, I-65, a view here a little north of 38th Street. Everything's moving along up to speed. We do have a police vehicle there on the right shoulder of the northbound lane, so keep that in mind. Just take it slow as you head past that area. Anytime you see an officer or anyone pulled over on the side of the road, make sure you move over a lane if you can and slow down so you can give them plenty of space. Everything here is still traveling, though, up to speed. No crashes to report right now, but we'll continue to monitor that area. Here's a look right now at I-465 and Mann Road on the southwest side. It's traffic here is moving along up to speed. No crashes to slow you down. So at this hour, rain is moving out of central Indiana, as Todd mentioned, but on Sunday, thunderstorms out in Bartholomew County causing a fire, leaving more than a dozen families without a place to stay. Just before 6 o'clock last night, Columbus firefighters received a call about heavy smoke coming from a building at the Stonegate Apartments. When crews arrived, they found flames coming from a roof of a two-story building. Residents were already evacuating, and it took about 2 hours to get the flames under control. 18 people were displaced and 12 units were damaged due to the fire. Thankfully, there were no injuries to report.
Lauren, Sunday was supposed to be the end of the Marion County Fair, but it was shut down following a shooting at the fairgrounds on Saturday. IMPD telling us that deputies were escorting juveniles from the fairgrounds after a fight when more than 100 others rushed the fair gates, forcing their way inside. After that, multiple fights started and at least one teen was shot. We spoke to a mother who was there with her son. She says she's glad they made it out safely and used that as a teachable moment.
Well, luckily for me, you know, I made it out safely and everything like that, but I'm trying to explain to him what it means to be an innocent bystander. It's not always like your situation that you could be affected by. And there were people there with their children and babies and infants and strollers, and it's just sad.
Officers tell us the boy who was shot is expected to be okay. A juvenile female and sheriff's deputy were also injured. The Marion County Fairground Board says despite that incident, they consider the 8 days a success, and they're working to make sure next year's fair is safe and secure.
Well, before you head out to the grocery store today or maybe your favorite restaurant this week, you'll want to check if they've updated their safety requirements. We know several businesses are starting new mask mandates this week, and so our Alyssa Donovan is joining us live this morning outside of one of the stores where face coverings will soon be required. Alyssa, good morning.
Good morning, Lauren. And starting this week, Kroger joins a growing list of major retailers that are issuing face mask mandates. And Kroger starts on Wednesday. Several of them start today, though, including CVS, Walgreens, Lowe's, and Walmart. If you go in those stores today, you do have to wear a mask. Kroger, along with Home Depot, will start requiring face masks starting Wednesday. Aldi and Target will also start requiring masks in coming weeks. Many of the retailers announced the masks will be available for customers that don't have one when you walk in the door. Several communities are also providing masks for those who need them. We asked people how they feel about the mandates.
Okay with wearing a mask. I think we all just need to do our own part and just try and help slow down the spread.
We should be able to make our own decisions. If we feel that we're at high risk, then, that we act appropriately.
Now, in a recent survey about businesses requiring customers to wear masks, 80% of Americans say they're more likely to do business with the company if they require staff and shoppers to wear masks during the pandemic. And if you need more details, rather, on which stores are starting those mask mandates this week and where you can buy a mask or find a mask for free, we have all those details on our website, theindychannel.com. Reporting live, Alyssa Donovan, RTV 6.
Alyssa, thank you. And as more cities and states and even retailers begin to enforce wearing a face covering, some groups are fighting back. On Sunday, dozens gathered at the State House hoping to get Governor Holcomb's attention. The group Stop Government Overreach in Indiana say that they're worried that requiring masks out in public will soon become a statewide issue. Those we talked to at the protest say they do care about other people and their well-being, but they believe that each person is responsible to take care of themselves.
We stand for freedom, our right under God to take care of our own bodies, and we can do that very well if we're allowed that liberty to do our very best.
I don't need to wear a mask for them to be safe. I'm responsible for my own health. They're responsible for their health.
The group also says they're upset that Governor Holcomb extended stage 4.5. Governor Holcomb says Indiana is seeing an uptick in the percentage of Hoosiers who are testing positive for COVID-19, and the state is basing the Back on Track Indiana plan data. We are expecting to stay on stage 4.5 for at least the next 2 weeks.
So, Lauren, the state is facing a spike in coronavirus cases. 927 new cases reported just on Sunday by the State Department of Health. That is the second highest daily total since the pandemic began. And the highest was back on April the 26th, when 946 cases were reported. Indiana has now 56,571 confirmed cases of COVID-19. Two new deaths were also reported on Sunday. So far, 2,629 Hoosiers have lost their lives to the virus. And this morning, 36% of ICU beds and 83% of ventilators are available statewide.
Well, this weekend, Indianapolis Public Schools announcing it will delay the start of the school year. Classes were scheduled to start on August 3rd. The new start date is now August 17th. District leaders say they made this decision based on data from state and local health leaders, as well as government officials. Superintendent Alicia Johnson says her team is ready to pivot and move with whatever the pandemic brings.
We know that flexibility and responsiveness have to be, our key priorities, particularly as it relates to safety. We've said from the beginning that we know, given the context of this virus, we need to be ready really at a moment's notice.
As of now, the district still plans to provide both in-person and full-time remote learning options. Registration for the virtual option has been extended. So far, about 8,500 students have enrolled in the remote learning option. That's about 25% of the student population. And just so you know, we are compiling a list of Central Indiana School District return plans. More are being added daily. You can look for details on our website. Just go to theindychannel.com. Raphael?
A good morning to Carmel, Anderson, and Frankfurt. This morning, an Indianapolis organization is helping Hoosiers keep a roof over their heads. Our Kelsey Anderson has much more on this innovative program. Kelsey, good morning.
The Interfaith Hospitality Network of Indianapolis used to house families in churches and temples, but because of COVID-19, they weren't able to do that. But it's worked out in their favor because now they're able to help more Hoosiers. Leola Jimenez and her son were calling a motel room home for a long time. That is, until the money ran out and they had nowhere to go. Now, through family promises, they are staying in this apartment, stocked with everything someone could need for up to 90 days. This gives Jimenez the opportunity to focus all of her attention and savings on getting into her own place. Family Promise guides them every step of the way to set them up for success once they leave the program.
Normally, we have 30 churches, congregations, and temples that work with us to provide transportation, food, as well as shelter for families. When COVID happened, all of that had to come to a stop because we wanted to keep our volunteers safe, as more importantly, our families safe as well.
Instead of churches, the families are now housed in apartment units. Program Director Veronica Williams says they are now operating at 89%, the highest rate they've ever seen of people being housed. Some landlords that are involved in the program will let those tenants just take over the lease once they're ready and those 90 days are up, while other landlords will only let them rent for 30 to 90 days. But once they've completed the program, they go to the top of the list for other units in the complex. Working for you, Kelsey Anderson, RTV6.
Kelsey, thank you. If you're planning a trip to the Indiana Dunes this summer, you're going to want to know about some new protocols. The National Park has launched a coronavirus safety campaign called Think Before You Beach. It includes new signage posted around Lake Michigan's shoreline and social media messaging. Park spokesman Bruce Rowe says the campaign reminds the public they can catch the virus outdoors on a crowded beach if they're not wearing a mask or properly social distancing. Rowe also says the best times to visit the lakes are late afternoons, early mornings, and weekdays. Beachgoers are encouraged to spread out and seek secluded or spacious areas. And Todd, would today be a good day to get outside, maybe head to the beach for anybody who's still home, kids still home from school in a lot of cases? What do people need to know?
Yeah, you know, it's probably not an A-plus of a day for the beach, but honestly, it's going to be warm enough, and even a little bit of cloud cover is going to probably help things out and prevent sunburns. So that could be a good opportunity for you maybe to get to the beach or the pool. What you obviously don't want is lightning, and don't have much of that in the forecast today. So that's good news if you are heading to the beach. And I definitely would not cancel any plans just because of this cloud cover and shower chance if that is in the cards for you and your family today. You see a few spotty showers out there this morning and heavier downpour here and there. But all the real strong storms are well off to our west in Omaha and Kansas City. That's where they will stay throughout the course of the day today. So as we work our way into the afternoon hours, you kind of read my mind, Lauren, with my pool planner here. We have temperatures in the mid-80s. It's warm. It's muggy. That UV index, though, down from a high to moderate level due to the added cloud cover. We'll talk more about your extended forecast when Good Morning Indiana continues right here on RTV6.
Welcome back. It is 5:46 here on your Monday. Here's a look at traffic as you're heading out on the roads this morning. This is I-65, a little north of 38th Street here on the northwest side, where traffic is moving along up to speed, both northbound and southbound. We'll continue to keep our eyes on your roads and let you know if there are any crashes or delays to slow you down this morning. Raphael?
Lauren, this morning, U.S. Marshals and the FBI investigating a shooting inside the home of a federal judge in the state of New Jersey. Investigators say that the gunman, dressed as a FedEx driver, arrived at the home of the judge, Judge Esther Salas, around 5 p.m. on Sunday. Her son was shot and killed when he opened that door. Salas' husband, a criminal defense attorney, was also shot multiple times. He was rushed to the hospital, and we're told that he's currently listed in stable condition after having surgery. Now, police tell us that the judge, Salas, was home at the time of the shooting, but she was not hurt. She has received threats in the past, but investigators are not sure if those threats are related to this shooting. And right now, police are still searching for that suspect.
Well, in Louisville, a lawsuit claims that Breonna Taylor was alive and suffering for 5 to 6 minutes after being shot. In an interview with investigators, her boyfriend said that she was coughing after being shot. He also said that police did not rush in to try and help her after those shots were fired, according to recordings released by his lawyer. The coroner refutes the claim, saying given Taylor's injuries, medical care could not have saved her life either way. Taylor, a 26-year-old EMT, was shot multiple times while police were executing a no-knock warrant back in March. Her death has sparked multiple protests calling for officers involved to be arrested. At 5:47, the UAE has successfully launched its first spacecraft that's bound for Mars, making history as the Arab world's first interplanetary mission. The spacecraft, called Hope, launched on Sunday morning from Japan. It is expected to reach Mars by February 2021, and it will remain in orbit for one Martian year, or about 687 days here on Earth. Although humans have never set foot on the planet, the race to get there has never been busier. Three countries, the UAE, China, and the U.S. are all embarking on missions this summer, taking advantage of the biennial window where the Earth and Mars are closest together. That is pretty cool, Todd.
Absolutely. I love seeing those kind of stories. So, I mean, I wish it wasn't a big competition to get to Mars. We can all work together, but I would love to see the pictures once they get there. So, all right, outside right now. We are talking about some showers that are still present across parts of central Indiana. They're all very, very light showers. They continue to fall apart. That is the good news in this forecast, at least going forward for your Monday. And as we go over to Storm Team 6 radar, you can see some light rain still from Rockville to Bainbridge. This is probably looks a little worse on radar than it actually is. It's just a few sprinkles, then a few sprinkles in the metro area as well. And then off towards the east, there's a few light rain showers near Economy and up towards Anderson. So as we go throughout the morning hours and even into the afternoon hours, honestly, can't rule out the chance of a spot shower, but nothing like we saw yesterday with those thunderstorms that came through with all the lightning and the real heavy rainfall. That is going to stay off to our west for the day today. Actually, tomorrow there's a better chance of some storms. So as we go throughout the day today, the overall trend will be for the clouds to gradually start to thin out, and we'll start to see More in the way of sunshine as the day goes on. And you stay on TrueCast here, that spot shower chance. But do not cancel any outdoor plans. If you're golfing, if you're going to the pool, if you're going to the beach, going to the lake, it's not going to be the brightest day for you. But honestly, if you're especially on the golf course with the cloud cover, it won't be bad at all. 60s and 70s, the current temperature is right now. So as we work our way throughout the day today, we're going to keep the temperatures hovering right around 71 to 72 degrees for the next few hours with the clouds in place. And then as those clouds thin, we'll see those temperatures eventually climb up into the mid-80s. Now, tomorrow temperatures are still in the mid-80s, but a little better chance in the afternoon of some thunderstorms coming through. So let me go back to TrueCast for you for the day tomorrow. And you could see some of these storms coming in throughout the afternoon and into the evening hours. They're on an isolated basis. There's more in the way of sunshine tomorrow, which is going to be added fuel for these storms. And so throughout the afternoon and evening hours tomorrow, I do think there is the chance of these storms, and some of them could be borderline strong to severe. The Storm Prediction Center has almost the whole state right now in the marginal risk for severe storms. By far the biggest threat tomorrow with these storms as they come through would be the potential for some damaging winds and maybe some small hail. We're not really looking at any flooding threat, or the tornado threat looks to be pretty low tomorrow as well. But added storms in the forecast for Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Temperatures in the mid-80s. And as we look ahead to the weekend, we're looking at temperatures that'll be hovering in the low 90s. Lauren.
All right, Todd, thank you so much. Let's take a look at traffic right now as you're heading out on the roads. The good news right now around the metro area, no crashes to slow down your commute. This is a look at I-65 and 30th Street. You can see traffic there is traveling up to speed both northbound and southbound. We'll continue to keep a close eye on those roads as you're heading out the door to start your work week. Raphael.
So, Lauren, it's kind of hard to have big birthday parties these days, but one mom isn't letting the virus stop her son's big celebration. That story coming up right here on Good Morning Indiana. Lauren and I welcome you back to Good Morning Indiana. And Lauren, I can see you doing this because among the team, you are the nicest and you have a dog. So this morning, right?
Oh, thank you.
The kindness of canines, of course, and their owners stepping up for a little boy in Wisconsin.
All right. Well, Raphael, we hope Todd's not listening right now. ABC's Tommy Alma shows us how the pups spent their weekend making a little boy's seventh birthday extra special.
Hi, everybody. It's me, Theo.
That's 7-year-old Theo Rensberger, a first grader from Milwaukee who was born with spina bifida. He loves dogs, but he doesn't have one of his own.
Whoa.
So when his birthday was approaching, his mom, Melody, wondered how to help her son celebrate.
Trying to think of what to do for your kid's birthday to make it memorable and special is hard at any time, but with the added element of COVID.
Melody had an idea, posting this message on Facebook. Theo's birthday's on Wednesday. He'll be 7. He'd love to have you stop by. If you have a dog, walk by our place.
Over the span of 7 hours, I think from 12 to 7, we had about 100 dogs.
That's right. About 100 dogs and their owners stopping by.
It was really humbling to think that people who didn't even know us would like drop their plans for the day or drive 45 minutes or delay their kid's nap and make a little boy's day.
Some even putting on party hats, giving Theo stuffed animals, and if they didn't have a dog, they borrowed one from their neighbor. They also made handmade signs and pictures.
And what are their names?
There's Cora, that's Bruce, and here's Buddy.
Who was your favorite dog that you saw?
Pinky.
Pinky, this little chihuahua right there in the owner's bag.
Having 100 people that I don't even know show up to care for my son in the midst of a crazy time of life was really special.
Oh, well, that is a special story and a special little boy there, Raphael. He's so cute.
See? I told you that you would be the one on the team to host or even partake in a pet parade.
Probably.
I mean, because you're nice.
Yes, and
Todd
I like
and I, maybe not so much. Todd, good morning. Your forecast is going to be okay today, right?
Yeah, you know, it's not a bad forecast. There's a chance of a few spotty showers this morning and again in the afternoon, but mixed in, we're looking at mostly cloudy skies with some sunshine eventually working into the forecast. It's got to be a little patient, I think, for that sunshine here this morning. But temperature-wise, it won't be bad. We're in the 70s this morning, going up to 87 degrees later on today for our high temperature. That's a few degrees actually above normal. Better storm chances in the forecast for tomorrow with the return of severe weather as a potential as well. We'll talk more about that coming up in just a little bit.